That's spelled D-I-L-L-I-G-A-F, Dilligaff. And this is what it means. Do I look like I give a fuck, Dilligaff? Am I being direct enough, Dilligaff? It's just another way of saying I couldn't give a fucking rat's ass, mate. And do I look like I give a fuck, Dilligaff? Your turn. Do I look like I give a fuck, Dilligaff?
You like to fuck around with some octopus?
Almost as bad as Jolson being down here.
Okay. We got to get through this whole thing.
No.
So, where do you want to start?
Probably a strawberry.
Strawberry?
The first press is regular apple cider.
You've had it?
Yeah.
Have you had the Grand Mimosa?
No, I haven't had any of the other three.
That'll all be changing. Maybe call Uber.
Well, it's a noon, 1 o'clock. You'll be fine by the time I gotta get home before you go to bed.
Okay. Yeah, you're in good shape. Oh, look, it's Remco. I wonder if he watched yesterday's review. Well, he's definitely watching. Yesterday, I should have just ended it where I was going there. Oh yeah, daddy lifey. Okay, the first one.
Strawberry.
You're gonna be drinking these so fast that I'm not even gonna bother putting them in the fridge. Too late now.
What?
I was gonna say, yeah, I put that one out for you. There's something in there, you can have it.
Yeah, it looks like apple juice.
The other option was the one from Founders.
10% something?
10.2%, like a chocolate imperial stout.
It smells like strawberry apple juice.
It does smell like fresh strawberry.
A little bit sour.
Okay, which one do you want to do next?
I got a drinking problem.
Come on, Jada. I'm just working on my recycling.
Mr. Holster, right?
Yes, Mr. Holster. Jesus, it's...
How long has it been since he took a drink in any short time?
Oh my God, I thought I was going to get beat up that day. It was like, I am literally showing these guys, I don't even realize over my shoulder he's going on like his third one.
Yeah.
Okay.
Are we going to save that video, or...?
You know... That was a B&E video, and I lost B&E videos before I even knew it was going to happen. They gave me, like, what, a strike? And then they gave me two more and closed the account, like, overnight. So, no, that was in the days before I was saving, so I do not have any of my videos on B&E or on eBomi. My video that we did with Justin, he started talking about some politics stuff, and this was in the days before you had strikes. They just deleted the video. They never informed me, and I never realized until me and NIHAP were talking about it.
And you went to look?
And I went back to go looking, and sure shit, so no. I'm trying to make good. Somebody, probably, you know who the somebody is. Sent me a bunch of hard drives in that toaster, and I literally have backed up everything since I got that stuff.
Awesome.
But at a certain point in time, when you have 20 gigs of videos, and you're going, is this ever going to... You know what's going to happen? I'm going to be dead, and...
Someone's going to find it. They're not even going to look through it. They're just going to toss the whole hard drive. Or just reformat it without looking.
And then I also like to think, you know, would the day come when one of my children say, this is what your crazy grandfather was like, but both of my children have informed me that they don't want to have kids. So Christine is sad.
Could happen.
It could, except for the only way Sam is going to have a baby is if she cheats, because Gage got the the old snippy snippy. They talked about it.
Does he have kids already, or?
I just
don't want to buy condoms.
I don't want to have this conversation, J-Dog.
Because anybody wants to talk about their family in that kind of way.
Can we not talk about my daughter's sex life? Okay, question.
Well, so how'd that go with having another friend marry your other daughter?
Well, you know.
They're not married now.
Didn't go over well.
No? You want to talk about nothing about the relationship, anything?
I don't really know. I think what the problem is no matter how much you say it won't affect your relationship with either one or the other, it always does. I mean, okay, here's a question. Obviously, you're driving, so I'm not. I'm just being funny. I'll drink all these without you.
I could have more than one.
But if there's three of each, and if it turns out that you really, really like, say, the strawberry, then I don't want to drink. I'll probably put at least one of them aside. Okay, this one you've had, so mm-hmm. This is like nothing new to see here. So now it's the as long as we're at this point. Mm. On a scale. Now this is the
cider scale.
Yeah, the cider scale.
It's probably 8.5.
I'd go 8.5. There's no artificial.
No, it's.
Yeah, it tastes like.
There's no extra color added, or.
It tastes like fresh strawberry and apple.
Work beer.
It's work beer. All of a sudden, Matt would be like, "Huh? Okay."
It sure wasn't his pile of bottles.
I was like, what are you... I know what you're talking about. That whole, let's find out who drank all my booze. And when he takes the mask off, it's him.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, Matt, you're talking about Matt. Yeah. When Matt found that pile of booze bottles, it was Matt's pile of booze bottles. Grand Mimosa or Blackberry?
This one's closer.
To you lazy fuck.
Well, I can reach a bowl.
Okay, is this going to be clear or is this going to have color?
Orange juice concentrate?
It looks like it has color. Slight.
It looks less filtered. The other one was clear.
And in case I didn't say it or he didn't say it, every one of these is 5%.
I brought some things to show you.
Speaking of that, you work tonight?
Nope. My weekend off. I don't have to work till Wednesday night.
So technically... Oh, that noise, that'd be... Christine coming home. Technically speaking,
I could do shots.
If we went straight on the shots.
Nah.
Are you expected home this evening?
Yeah. I just.
Even more important.
Does
she care if you never came home again?
Well, somebody's got to put her fucking floors in.
Wow.
6 years later, they're not all in yet. Just the bedroom. Let's get more furniture to put in the way of putting the floors in.
Hey, did you actually hear the part where I said if you need someone to take care of the driveway to call me?
No, I didn't see that.
Damn it. Did you need someone?
No, my buddy had a plow truck, but he sold it. Oh. And I messaged him and was like, hey, but you sold that too soon, huh? Because his driveway is not short, and I don't think he had any other way to...
You know, don't you know how this works?
If you have a plow truck, you sell it, and then you need it?
No. Well, that part too, but that whole, you're supposed to be one of those,
tell your buddies that
typical asshole friends, because I'd be able to get to your house, because your tire is on the front of my truck, I should have, no, I said in the brewery review, I thought I said it early enough on, but yes, it's always obscure, that if you need me to come over and run down the driveway, I will. In your case, if the shit ain't there, I can literally drive in one end of your property straight through to the other end.
See, the only problems I have with needing would be if I don't get out soon enough with the snowblower on the ends where the town or village or county comes by.
Jesus, I don't know if it's because we have a new mayor. There's been... 2 trucks through our alley. Last year, we were seasonal. In other words, I bet you weeks went by before anybody ever came through our alley. Twice. And wow, that was nice. I just missed that. First the grader went by, and then a plow truck the following day out front. And of course, it's that crumbly ass shit, and it was done at 10 o'clock at night. So now it's 10 o'clock the following morning, and I go out there, and I brought out my little tiny... I've got this really awesome little grain shovel that I keep in the truck, but it can take so much abuse. You could probably use it to hack down a tree. And I'm clearing it, beating the... I have to break off chunks to get that grader shit. And I look over, and Matt's walking out with his plastic shovel, and I'm like, that ain't gonna work, Matt.
Did you get one of those cold steel shovels in any of those boxes?
Those little guys?
Yeah, the Spetsnaz shovels.
Wooden handle. I've had two, well, they fold up so they fit
It's just a wooden shovel.
No.
But it's like 2 feet long.
No, I don't think so. Not a shovel yet.
The one of the guys from Malone had one.
Oh, he didn't make that? He actually bought, you can actually buy something just like that?
That short shovel he was hacking shit? Yeah.
Axe? It was like a saw on one side, an axe on the other, and a shovel in the middle.
That one might have been a Condor, but Condor makes one. Cold Steel makes a Spetsnaz shovel, and then they have one with a little bit longer handle.
No, just the survival shovels from 2 different companies. The last one was from...
You got 2 Gerbers? Or?
One was a Gerber, and the other one, which is even nicer, I don't remember who makes it. One, the Gerber is in my car, and the nicer one's in the Honda. When I mean nicer, it has a much bigger handle, it seems like it's better made, and it had a bigger shovel on it. So it was all around it was a little bit bigger.
I got cheap shovels from Menards.
But still, the fact that it takes up something the size of a med kit, and I can at least use it to save my ass.
Mine's like a 4-foot butt.
Oh, so if you... you didn't watch the whole brewery review. So, you know what? The problem that I'm having with the driver's front tire of my truck, right? Guess what I found yesterday in the passenger rear tire of the fucking Subi? And those are 4 brand new tires on there.
Another one?
A goddamn screw. At least it's in the very center of the tread and not in my fucking sidewall. So it's repairable. But it's been there for quite a while. Because it goes from 33 PSI to 26 PSI and then triggers the sensor, and it takes it 2 weeks. And this has happened to me twice now. So it's been in there for over a month, and it just slightly...
Probably was in there when you got it?
No, Sam had all the tires off of the car to polish out the rims. She put them back on and then balanced all 4 of them for me. My little Sammy Poo, I think if she could ever afford a small garage for herself, she could be kind of like that dude out east or out west, because she likes to pick up cars from auction and then spend a month repairing everything.
She need an all-wheel drive dyno?
Oh, that would also be fun. for that's if you only did Subarus.
Well, you don't have to only put all-wheel drive on them. I think you can like back something up the other way on them. I think they spin both ways.
You're saying they're lesbian cars?
The dyno. Right. The dyno's bi.
Gotta buy dyno. Buy dyno. See, I could...
I don't know. I've never messed with the dyno. Never had enough money to put into anything for a dyno.
I
mean, if I didn't buy guns.
I would be curious as to the actual horsepower number with Vivian. I bet you Vivian has more horsepower than the Subaru. Well, no. Sam says a stock Impreza is 2-something, like low 2s.
Now, the problem with the Imprezas is since, like, I paid attention to cars in, like, 2003 when I first saw the STIs and was paying attention to cars, got into cars, the cars are, like, twice as big as they used to be. Trucks have kind of done that too.
Kept getting bigger.
Uh huh.
Well, you compare it with like a.
So I got a F-250 sitting in my driveway that I need to get rid of because we don't have a title for it. Had the title. Dipshit lost the title.
You know, whenever you say dipshit, how come I always know exactly who you're talking about? And his name may or may not rhyme with dandy.
Yeah. He don't watch this.
It's like, he seems to be like the eye of the storm of fuckery. It's like if it could go wrong, problem is most of his problems always seem self-inflicted.
He doesn't listen.
Must have some female genes in him.
He wears them. That's a joke, because he's into guns too, but he won't buy any of the gear that goes with the guns, like magazines and pouches and belts and whatever. So, the standing joke is, where are you going to put your magazine? In your sister's jeans? Because he had skinny jeans, got them at the mall with the fancy stitching on the pockets or whatever. I called them his sister's jeans. Whatever.
I don't know how you feel about that, but compared to the strawberry, I would drop for sure at least a half a point.
I like the strawberry better.
Yeah. If that's an 8.5, if the strawberry is an 8.5, that's at least an 8.
This one says Grand Mimosa. Shouldn't it be a little bubbly? Maybe?
It's not bubbly? You know, ciders aren't really... Okay. Okay, going off of what we learned last time, the blackberry, I'm saying, is not clear. Even though, if that's the case, the strawberry should have been red.
It's okay.
Okay, here. And...
Oh, no, it's clear. Clearer than the orange.
It still has... It looks more orange than it does blackberry, though, but...
It's darker than... It looks more red than the strawberry.
It smells really good, though. Great, maybe I should have got 2 12-packs. One for you and one for me.
Nah, I'll have one of each. It's all them calories.
Yeah, that's what I'm concerned about.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to have to go for an extra walk tomorrow now.
Start them comments.
Did I start it?
We gotta start the comments. There's only a few this time though.
Well, we started off with 35, so. Okay, first in is Rich saying cheers all and being first. Mr. 27 says first, really being second. What the fuck? Why is this thing? I keep like keeps like zipping up to the halfway point. Not even touching it. Multi-gunman says, your first what? Then he says, then Mr. 27 says, live long and brew bomby intro. Nice. Multi-gunman says, set phasers to whiskey. Poco says, here. Multi-gunman says, there. Poco says, E5. E5 has already been called as a miss. Salty says, a naked man is a wise man. And Multi-Gunman says, what if a man is partially clothed?
I'll give that one an 8. The Grand Mimosa.
I agree. I just a half a point behind it. It's still, I mean, I've not a...
I wouldn't complain if I had a fridge full of them. But it,
no.
It would be there for a while because I don't really drink anymore. Eric doesn't drink any less.
Hey, so did you see the other video where I got a lecture for my drinking from Matt?
Okay.
Like, what? See, the one big difference is, in a 24-hour window, if I have anything to drink...
We usually see it?
You pretty much see it. Now, I have... Like, during Locked and Loaded, I ended up having two scotch.
Yeah, well, you had to go get a new one.
Yeah.
Because you blew the other one out your nose.
Okay. How good is your memory? How far into the show? I listened to the show 3 times yesterday, hitting the 10-second button, and could not find that. Because Dave goes, what the fuck did I say that made you blow scotch out your nose?
Was it something about Miss B?
I don't remember if it was her or Mike. He thinks he might have said something about Mike when we were talking about his nose. But I started the show.
I don't...
And it has the 10-second button. And I kept going, 10 seconds. I figured we were laughing so long. How could I possibly miss it? But after I could not find that moment in the show after 3 attempts. And then I came to the conclusion that it can't possibly be as funny as all the work that I'm putting into
trying
to find it. Oh, don't forget your book while you're here, too.
Yeah, I gotta give you some money.
Whatever. I'm not worried about it.
Okay.
I mean, shit.
Should I told you to keep the cash from Mrs. B's book giveaway?
You know, the funny thing is Christine is now...
Then you can go through and find a book with cash in it.
Christine has now taken money out of my wallet twice in the last 3 days.
And you're the one not working?
And I'm the one without the job. It's just like, I go, you know, there is something so wrong about what you're doing. I haven't found a fucking place I'd want to put that. It's not just a magnet, it's a frame magnet.
Oh.
So it's like made for the...
So the gun stays in a grabbable direction?
Yeah. Like, it'd be like, I'd want to put it like, say, under here, or next under a toilet. Desk. Next to the... Well, you've seen my layout. I'm better off with the revolver and the Ziploc baggie and the tank of the toilet. Maybe. The problem is maybe between the wall and the radiator... But
it's not enough room to get in there and, like, grab it.
That, and I don't know if I'd want a gun constantly in the bombardment of a radiator that gets hot enough that you can't hold your hand on it. Yet Christine puts electronics and her makeup on it all the time. It's like, how long did the makeup mirrors last that spend their entire existence? Now, having said that, if you look behind my desk, there's a power strip that has been on there since the dawn of time that everything plugs into, and that's laying directly on the radiator. I love that radiator right there, though, because my desk and the wall form a barrier. I take wet gloves and wet hats and just throw them back there.
Here's the not silver gun he wants.
See, but that just is, that makes it completely so I don't want it at all.
It says Ladysmith.
It doesn't look like Miss Parker's gun, though.
This is the 14. Hers is the 13.
I know. Give. But just like when some people go out and they have to have certain guns because they were in a movie or whatever.
Hey, by the way, Miss Parker's gun is also in the first Men in Black.
Who has it in that?
Will Smith's character in the beginning.
Oh, really?
That was the gun he was carrying as a detective.
Exactly like Miss Parker's?
Yeah, I think he had an NL, the non-logo.
See, the problem is the price is right, and the only thing that changes between this and Miss Parker's gun
is the color,
and it can double in price.
What was that? What did that one guy want? $9-something?
$9-something! And his wasn't even in good shape.
See, I got this one. The Ladysmith, $39.14. And then I have a regular $39.14 with the straight dust cover. I like this one.
What's the difference between them?
Just the dust cover. The frame is different. And they don't work in the same holsters. Because there's more material here.
Okay. Boy, it's so freaking close though. But yeah, it's definitely a unique.
And the slides are actually a little different too. It cuts on the slide.
Mm-hmm. Rolled on that one. And then, kind of and cut then, out on that one.
Yeah.
No, I have to eventually have the other one.
I just want all the Smith & Wessons.
Well, I won't argue with that, but in the order for which I would like... I know this is going to sound like something that you'd go, I want to call bullshit. I would rather have, in the order in which I own them, right now I would rather get my hands on Miss Parker's Ladysmith in the right color sequence than either of the, what, I'm missing three 10mm in the original Smith & Wesson lineup.
1046, which has no controls and it's double only.
Yes. Then
the 1026, which is the longer 1076.
And I think that was the one that I had for a while.
Yeah, you did a video on that one.
And there's one more. I'd have to look.
1086? Sounds maybe? I don't know. I just know I want the 1066. You can keep all the rest. I just want a 1066.
What is it? A 1047?
The 1046.
1046?
It has the same slide, but it would be like on a 1066 frame where there's no controls and it's double action only.
Kind of like that a gun I got from Jim. Except for it's all steel. The one I got from Jim is aluminum frame and steel slide. Am I drawing a blank on what even that is?
Something 46 probably?
Yeah, something in there.
I know I brought it back down. I mean, the 76 is cool because it's an FBI turn-in. So that would be
a 40-43. And that's a
double
action only.
And those have a different hammer in.
It's like double action only, but still requires a reset.
Mm-hmm. Kind of like the DAKs. Or the Well, that one's even different than the HK LEM triggers. Because those will still have a long pull after you pull it, but it also has like a precocked. Does that not fit it right?
I think it's because it's got a lot of use. This gun got carried as a work gun for a long time, and so it got carried under the worst case scenarios.
That, and it's got a... It's just riveted.
Yeah, there's no...
There's no adjustability.
There's no,
Somebody could fix it.
Probably the same guy that made this one. This also...
Is that an old?
Yes, this also might have been like one of his prototype.
So, yeah, does he have a dummy for a 69 series? A 6906? I know a red dummy gun showed up here because I sent the sender the link for it when I bought one. Because I think it showed up around the same time the green gun showed up. That one right there. Only mine didn't come in a box.
You know what I need? It's like more place to not put stuff.
Is that one lift off or is it? This is not the one I have.
That says Smith & Wesson 10mm.
So that's the same as the 1066.
So you want to know if he can make a holster for...
For a 6906. I mean...
That motherfucker. I gotta get back to that one as soon as I send this.
Yeah, this is a 10mm.
Can you make a holster for a 6906?
Fucking Jared. Yeah, 10/45. I thought he sent you the same one that I had. The compact.
This fucking guy. Happy Transgender Day.
Did you see that? Apparently, an executive order about making a day about bullshit.
That today, Transgender Day?
Mental health. Fucked up day.
Just act like they're not even here. Shh. Fuck that.
I'm gonna say I like this one the least. It's not bad. What, a 7.5?
Do you consider yourself religious?
Probably not. Do I have faith? Do I believe in things? Yes. But organized religion? No.
So would you consider this too far?
Not really, because I have a sense of humor.
See, that's just it. I still think you can be like super religious and still
would
have
David
a sense of
this?
Humor.
Would David want one of these?
Is that the all steel?
I don't want the aluminum.
That would get him closer. You'll have to bring it with sometime.
The MMP 2.0 metal. I think that's what the model was. Metal.
Yeah, I think they just referred to it as metal.
I need to shoot this one more. I've shot it, but it needs to be shot more.
Can you, have you tried interchanging this?
With?
Like?
I don't think I have that same side. I did recently get another Smith & Wesson, but I traded in one and some cash. Is that a 4.25? Is that the same length as this one?
Yeah.
Is it 4-inch? I thought that one had a 4.25.
How much is sticking out past the... Want to touch tips?
It's a little bit longer. Yeah, it's a 4.25.
Have you shot my 10mm?
No, I shot mine.
As I say, if you want to fondle it, I'll have to go get it. It's another one that I won't. I put the Holosun that I got from Twin Ports Bid on it.
So this is a 2.0 compact. I had one of the original 2.0 compacts with the hinge trigger. I traded that one in some cash for the one with the optics cut. And this one matches my 10mm because I got the 4-inch.
In the world of give a shit, this is all you have to have.
I have a VP9 at home. Not the new tactical one. They want $1,000 for that gun at Shooters.
That's nuts. Do you know that this was $1,200?
New? Or with the MSRP?
When it first came out.
Yeah.
Now, you can find it for $499
or $599? No, I think that one's $799 most places, if you can find the deal.
And then start adding a few accessories to it.
Surprised you didn't get an EPS.
What?
The EPS site, the enclosed emitter.
Yeah. We've already talked about this.
Yes.
It's a fucking $100 more than that one, and that one was expensive.
Well, I will tell you what, that $100 is worth it when you don't have to fucking dig in there with something to fucking clean all your body schmutz.
Every day?
Yeah.
Every day. Time I carry it?
Uh-huh.
Like tonight, I've already had to clean it out once today already.
Because I don't have the 507. I have two 407s, and then the 407K, which is on my Glock 43, and I quit carrying that because I was sick of cleaning it.
I don't know.
Because
I have a home I could put that on if I could afford to upgrade that to.
But then you have to buy the new.
A new mount?
New plate. $50?
Yeah. Yeah, this thing is just a fucking tap driver.
And then that one guy don't have to worry about his PL7 anymore because I found another one.
That one guy?
Yeah, that one guy. Yeah, his PL7's safe now because now I have two. I have the original duty.
I think I might have one of those.
No, that other one is this one.
Oh.
And then the green bag with all the mags.
Yeah.
Yeah. By the way, these mags are still different than the P10C mags.
Not just length, but like lockup and shit.
No. The base plates are different. Because this one has a little curve.
Oh.
What did I do with that holster? Let's see what I got. Another one of Pete's holsters.
You wouldn't happen to have a picture of it, do you?
What?
Picture
what?
It's this. If I do a, he said send me a picture. I think so. If I find a stock 6906 on the internet, like he could already be doing.
It's like a half inch shorter. You have one in there.
Oh, okay.
You have a 6906.
I know which one, yeah.
Because that's the one
I've never shot it.
We shot that one.
Have we?
Yeah. Because I was like, oh, I want one of these.
Norris.
Well, there's one way to make the video longer.
This always works better when I do. Okay, I lied. It's not working out better.
It's just like you measure what the difference is, the length difference between the 69 and the 59. I think it's a half inch shorter.
Actually, I wouldn't be surprised if this holster works.
It will work, but it's just longer.
If this was tightened up, the holster you made me for my 4043
is about a half inch
long. Is the same size, but the holster for the 4043 is just a little bit longer.
About a half inch long.
So if that's the case with the holster for the 5906.
Yeah, it'll fit. It's just longer.
Or Or was this the holster for the 5906 and I just put the 4043 in it?
Same.
Yeah. Oh, actually the holster that I'm comparing it with might actually be the holster for the 5906. Which makes it just a little bit longer than the... ...6906.
Ow!
Now would you hit your head on?
A fucking Pez dispenser.
The Pez dispenser.
Yeah, the D60. Oh no, that's a D50.
That's on a 2010. That's a D50.
Yeah, I don't say that's a...
Oh, I got my P10C here. I'm showing you the difference on those magazines. This is the older P10 with the ambidextrous safety. Yeah, see the... magazine difference? The flat?
Hey, I saw a video where those guys had alcohol and firearms. Hold my beer and watch this, bitches!
Out of carry rotation, so that's loaded.
Carry rotation?
Yeah. I carry a few things.
All at once?
Sometimes I carry more than one gun.
I was thinking about getting a holster for this.
Well, now I find out after the book is written, I'm in it. Until he told him, like, hey, you call him Jimmy Three Guns. Because he's always carrying three guns. It's been a minute since I carried three guns. Yeah. How many minutes are they off camera fucking around with other shit instead of reading comments or something?
Did you see the latest?
The operator? I know somebody with an operator, but he's got the full lip rail. There's another storage. Never mind.
No. That was a trade.
What did you trade?
Ruger 5.7.
Oh, you just traded that.
And the Beretta 22.
Because what's his name likes it so much?
Charlie.
Yeah.
I think it's awesome to see where he has come from wanting to wear women's dresses to actually from wearing women's dresses and girls' panties to actually enjoying shooting. So I encourage it.
I want to get that new one of those new T-SOS double stack nines.
I got one. I think it's might be a piece of shit.
You got that's a Gearson 9mm single stack though.
I have not brought that out since. I keep forgetting about it.
Did you try it once?
Did I?
I thought you brought it out once. Oh, somebody.
Did it work?
I don't think so. It could be magazines. But I was just pissed off because I sent, like, hey, if this gun doesn't work, shouldn't that be a warranty issue? So I brought it back to the store I bought it from. They sent it in, no problem. Then they tell me, hey, it came back in. Come get it. By the way, we need $90.
Bullshit, you do.
So yeah, I never took it back out because I was
pissed. You did a David J. fucking Brown, didn't you?
Huh?
Fuck him.
Well, I sold it for a lot less than I paid. So.
I don't remember if I did or I didn't. I remember saying.
I thought there was a video.
Maybe. Huh.
Anyways, I sold it with it. It doesn't work. It's not my problem. I didn't try it after they sent it in. There should be a whole jar of these guys.
Yeah, no. There? No, there's not.
No, there's not.
I'm surprised you didn't hear a response from just the...
Just
the dry fire. The dry air fire.
Yeah.
You better not be shooting anything down. Yeah, other than that.
Yeah, get a whole wall of sparkle over there.
Go to pull... How many times did you go to the kitchen and go get a paper towel?
And BBs come out?
And BBs come.
Well, better than using... You could use that, but then they just zing everywhere else.
Ting, 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 ting. Okay.
Next video.
Comment two. Smile money. So, the envelope I mailed you didn't arrive yet. It's been 5 business days. I was informed through UPS, PUC, PPC, poo-poo, that it was supposed to arrive, I'm guessing tomorrow.
Yeah, sure, this will be this one. Maybe she'll want one of these.
Another Smith?
Yeah, I kind of like them.
Which one is this?
That's the Shield Plus. That's my second one. Because sometimes I find sales and deals on guns and I just buy them because they're inexpensive.
Well, you could show it to her, but I'm just starting to get the feeling that she's just like somehow turned into not a small gun person.
Well, she's not going to carry a P-30. Because, you know, she just wanted it because it's a John Wick gun. But you went and bought it for her carry permit.
Yeah, that went well for me.
I have one of those in the truck. Never mind, no I don't. Mine's 9.
You don't have a 40? A 40C?
No, I have a 40. I got the full size. I got a police trade-in 40. With 2 extra barrels, the 9 and the 357. Sharky shot the 357 barrel while he was here.
You know who that is?
Yeah, fucking Albanian.
The Albanian storage.
Well, yeah, because he wanted to keep something here so he could carry one.
Except
he's
been here once.
since he's... I think he's... I've seen him here twice.
Are you sure?
One time for sure.
I think he's only been here one time.
Knyhap was here too.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
I have shot this. I actually ended up experiencing a bunch of problems with it.
Mm-hmm.
And I polished the shit out of the chamber and the ramp. And the last time I had it out, I had no problems. So.
Well, you have plenty of ammo to try it.
Thank
you, Mr. Holster.
Mainly because I had a few 40s on hand to start with, and then I stopped carrying and shooting. I can't even tell you the last time I brought a 40 cal out to shoot it.
I think I only have one left. I traded Jolson mine for that 5906.
And then of course Scott gave me two great big ammo cans, one with range and one was defensive.
Is in the J-Dog lineup.
Mm-hmm. There's this one.
Is that a 40 or 9?
9.
Well, mine's got... I got a factory 9mm barrel in my 40, so... It might not be factory because it started.
You have a threaded barrel, one of these?
Yeah. Hmm. And a 357 barrel for it. Sharky shot that while he was here.
And the one thing that's cool about this is that it actually has night sights.
Mine came with night sights. Is a police trade-in. Dude, police trade-ins are a hell of a deal.
Obviously, this was not, because it has...
I almost bought another one.
You barely even tell it's been fired.
I almost bought another police trade-in MP, but then the,
I don't even know if I've even shot this.
IRS decided they were going to help themselves from my bank account. My fault for not paying them, but whatever. It's not how I wanted to pay them. Yeah.
Last but not least. There was this one time at band camp. Okay, let's go back to that one. What, the strawberry had color to it, didn't it? Just, it looked like
maybe
this.
Maybe a little more than that.
Okay.
And here's the Blackberry Wild. A little bit darker.
Oh, and neither one of us have given a rundown on that. I
said 7.5.
Oh, okay.
I like it the least so far.
I would go 7.5 too, because it's my least favorite of them right now because of the order. It would be strawberry, orange, mimosa,
blackberry wild. Yeah, see, that's what happened the other day. Fuckers.
What?
See the title?
Yeah.
They can do that whenever they want, I guess. Pay your taxes, kids. And that's from like two years ago, Texas? I don't know. All I know is Wisconsin no longer has reciprocity with taxes with Minnesota, so my taxes, state taxes, don't get paid. But Minnesota will take all the taxes out, and then they don't want to give it back. So I changed my exemptions to pay them as little as possible. Because if they're not going to give it back, I'm not wasting $40 a fucking...
Well, why give them a fucking free loan?
They don't want to give it all back in the first place. Why give them any? And then I got to pay to have that extra state filed in the first place.
Not that I'm bitching, because it's another 10mm. But I definitely like, what is it, the TRP version of this? It's got all the nice strapping.
Mm-hmm.
I believe it's also might be a longer.
Some of them do, some of them don't. Oh, you got a police trade-in TRP operator with a full dust cover.
All I know is the thing is...
But his is 45.
The thing is definitely more accurate than me. It's a...
Well, drink some more coffee before you go to the ring and see what happens.
Yeah, I don't understand what my problem is. You want to talk to her?
Yeah, Lily?
Yeah. What are the odds that she'd call during a bird review?
You don't even do it. What's worse is you don't even do it at the same time all the time. Like, it used to be later. And she'd call.
I know, it's...
2 o'clock?
This is early for a review, and way early for her to call.
Maybe she's trying to game the system.
Hang on, I gotta check on Sharky.
Oh, hey, it's right here. I told you had a whole bottle full of those.
No, I don't.
No, you don't. Fill it up and shoot you in the ass.
God damn it. Sharky says to thank J-Dog for being able to shoot your stuff. You were too generous.
Hey, if you want to come back, you can shoot the rest. It'd probably be about 10, 20 new ones by then.
He just got to the end of the review. Said he spilled his beer.
I haven't seen the whole review, so...
I read all the ending, the club comments, and I talked for a couple of seconds, and I go, well, I suppose before we go, and I hit refresh, and it was Sharky saying, I made the club, happy clubbers, or whatever the hell his comment was, and I intentionally didn't heart it, and hung out a little bit longer, and then I hit refresh, and he commented to himself, saying, well, I guess I missed it. Oh, I couldn't stop laughing. It's fucking too good.
So... these are the ones Matt was talking about using?
I think so.
You know you're supposed to use a rifled barrel with these, right?
But what if you don't? It's just not going to be as accurate.
I mean, what are you using it for? Are you trying to hunt with it, or are you just shooting somebody across your house? Probably doesn't fucking matter.
I would shoot someone coming through my front door with the Lynx with it.
It doesn't matter then. Close enough. It could tumble, or whatever. It's still going 1,600 feet per second or whatever there. At that distance, it really doesn't matter.
Yeah, that's why I was like going, you know what, I realize that your accuracy is going to...
But these are also not 1 ounce slugs. They're 300 grain.
Hey, did you see that one on, what's his name? Tandiferous,
Tau Fledermaus?
Tandon, that guy?
That guy, Tau Fledermaus?
The one that had the rounds that were backwards, the 22 rounds.
I don't want to know what's in there.
I got it from Matt, if that answers the question. No, I got it from my sister. Matt would approve, though, if that answers the question.
Here, I'm playing with things I might not want to play with that.
Let's just say if you get pulled over on the way home, the dog's going to go fucking nuts.
Well, I don't think I got any on my fingers, but I don't know what was else on the outside, so.
Jizz. No, it's a 12-gauge round with some 22 rounds backwards in it.
I think I saw that.
So when they hit, it causes them to explode.
They detonate.
It seemed like
something like a more dangerous to the shooter.
Well, it's just no. It I think they're capped, so it causes them to explode. Because they're mainly like for a ram set or something like that.
Ram set rounds. Or charges, because it's not a round.
Yeah. All I know is it really.
I like freckles.
Every freckle is another...
A soul?
Another soul. This bitch is taking a lot of them. Din says, J-Doc, they're in the basement.
Yeah.
Okay, Smiley. Most of the homes in your section of town go for less than $260. Now, if Matt's truck payment wasn't higher than some people's mortgage, and he didn't need $40,000 in dental work, he'd buy a house and stop drinking in his truck.
Hey, he could buy Miles' house.
Then Smile Money says, I can't wait to see those groupings from the trip to the shack. Take your digital calipers.
Well, you could just take a picture. I don't know about the shack. For 100 yard, I would go to Island Lake. I'd be able to do the video a lot sooner.
Then he says, I wrote the above comment using pew-pew terms, and they deleted it. I hope your freedom seeds are compatible. Jesus Christ, I can't believe it. YouTube is just great. Smile Money says, kidney stones, those are painful. Hope the surgery went well. I heard you say that you read David's book at the hospital, so now I know the rest of the story.
Yes. An entire day of drinking.
Red Solo Cup. I'll fill you up. Jolson says I-3. It's already been called as a miss. EMT says, here's to Poco.
That's why I don't play. Because I'm over here enough to see it.
Those are...
Or sometimes not see it.
Those look like...
The adult version of a playground.
They look like they taste really good. I'm willing to try.
So EMT is having a shot to Poco.
Nope.
Nope. How about a skull shot?
Nope.
How about... What's your primary nationality?
Dude, I'm probably mostly Finnish. At least a quarter. But the rest of it, who knows?
So you want to strip off your clothes and go lay in the snow?
Fuck no.
Yeah, well, I'll take his advice. Bad says, greetings, Captain.
Greetings, Bad.
EMT says... Doggy Style 7 and
Bunch of Biden.
Well, since there's no S, we'll just go with D7. D's nuts. D7 happens to be a hit. Cheap old gun guy. Human life is but a series of footnotes to the vast, obscure, unfinished masterpiece. One of those footnotes is...
Bunch of Biden!
Put this away.
Just keeps pulling out fucking guns.
Hey, at least you're traveling light.
That's because I got a truck gun now. Technically guns.
Truck guns.
Well, my MP9 compact is in the lockbox with 3 mags. And then...
I still have not shot this.
Was that the third one? Yes.
Is it?
Well...
Yeah, that's the thing.
Somebody wanted one because it was like the gun from the cartoon show. Right?
Well...
Cowboy Bebop?
God bless somebody's soul. Samantha has one, Christine has one, and now the rightful owner has one.
For now. For now. Well, that one.
I
the M&P Bodyguard?
I only bought that one because it was the right price and I had ammo at home. Non-laser?
God.
You can wear this in just your underwears. Because it won't pull them down.
That's a 9?
No, that's 380.
I guess I've never owned a 380.
That's the only one I got. And that was the only one I was interested
in. There has been one here. I distinctly remember doing a video one day and I threw the gun past the camera and it bounced off the wall over there. That was that High Point. And it ended up getting, it was a giveaway. And what's her name? She was one of these women. It was the curse of our giveaways. She did, personal favorite. She used to do videos all the time. And then she won she got the AR-15 and that pistol. And it was literally the second to the last video that she's done since then. She was a prepper. I think I would become a dead man if I said, you're going to have to get another one of these. They are nice. I mean,
CZ-75 copy.
I love shooting the one that Christine has. And
does she have the IMI?
Mm-hmm.
Or did Sam get the Baby Eagle?
Sam has the 941 Jericho, and Christine's is a Baby Eagle. If I was to steal one from the lineup, it would be this one because I like the sights better.
It's got a rail?
Yeah, and it has a rail. Christine's has GI sights, so it's just
just a little bar?
Just a little bar. But I've already overstayed my welcome, I feel, at the Holiday Inn Express. And
here's what I would do. If I'm going to buy one, I'd probably just buy a PO1.
And hopefully you don't get a POS?
Yeah. Hey, I don't have any problems with the CZs that I got.
No. Am I going to have to go get the bag? You won't cry anymore anyway.
Huh? What?
If I go get the bag.
The CZ, the PO7?
Yeah.
I just bought another one.
That's what I said. At least you won't cry.
Yeah, anymore. I just bought another PO7. Because the other one, I kind of wanted to keep that one.
It's badass.
How far is it buried?
I don't know.
It's not buried, but it's what you'd call...
It can stay in there. It doesn't gotta come out.
Yeah. There's three firearms in front of it.
This one's double action, but it doesn't have a decocker.
Hopefully it wasn't supposed to have.
No, I don't think so. It's a 941. There were some decocker models, but they've had so many different models
and
configurations.
And they have a holster for it. Let's yes. Yeah. And the rat rod that she's in, too. Also. McClellan, Eric, are you down there making the change to those picks? McClellan, the last car across the bridge was me. I had Taco Bell. McClellan, heard about a lot of pews and not one Hellion.
It's because there isn't one. Not here, anyways.
EZE? Wow, making me want a bloody right now, and it's 10 p.m. Nicely done. Hey, don't let the clock interfere with that. And who in the hell are you? 8 subscribers.
No videos, just a playlist.
Okay, well, he didn't leave a shitty comment, so I'm subbing. I'm subbing back. Matt Davis says, G9. G9 is a miss. Then Matt says it's $4.35 and up here in Seattle. I was talking about gas, so he's...
It's $3.89 and it's a quick trip down the street, and across the bridge it's $2.79, or $3.79 for regular, or that's diesel.
Well, I know the gas has gone up because it just cost me almost $60 to fill the Subaru, and I have never paid $60 to fill the Subaru.
Yeah, I also haven't had it that long.
No, but...
You've been driving the shit out of it?
$32, I think, the first time, $44 the second time, and now 50.
I don't even know the last time I filled a vehicle with fuel, with gasoline.
Well, I do know that you're not feeling any better when you go, if you take the Dodge and go fill it up, though.
Oh, it's over $100.
I was sort of employed. This was back, Greg, when I was working for JRJ Properties, you narcissistic little bitch.
So he was the problem?
Well, he did go to Jack and say, if I find out Eric is working for any more JRJ Properties, I'm going to pull all my tools and I'm walking off the fucking job, and you can find someone else to finish it. I told Jack, I said, let him. I can finish it. There isn't anything left to be done that I don't feel comfortable doing. It's mm-hmm. Do you think that you could go to your boss and give a list of fucking demands, like swearing at them, and you'd still have a job tomorrow?
I could probably swear at my supervisor, but not the rest of them. Not anybody in the office building.
I was gonna say, this is the guy that actually writes the check. He doesn't actually write it. He has people. That's where he is. The guy that actually is paying you, and you're so fucking caught up in yourself, let alone the fact that I know everybody always says there's the rest of the story, or there's the what I haven't heard, or there's two sides of every argument. Because trust me, as a redhead, I used to get into fights all the time, and all I ever heard is, it always takes two to tangle. I go, okay, so how many hits do you want me to wait next time before I defend myself? It was always like the amount of times that I was sitting in the fucking principal's office because someone was going to pick on the redhead. Well, guess what? The fucking redhead isn't going to sit there and take it. Yeah. Greg has just made it so abundantly obvious as to why I feel so much better that I don't work with him. Guess what? If you happen to see this, Greg, construction, as it turned out, construction really isn't the problem. It's you. But I just don't want to do construction anymore. Poco, prayers for Poco. Oh, sorry, Wade says prayers for Poco. I think you did the Scotch nose... within 10 minutes of David starting to talk. Okay, I'm going to have to go back and try to find it. Wade, I'm too old and too fat to be tactical. I do my best to hit what I'm aiming at. Would you hit that? Wade, I can't help myself when something like a ship hits a bridge and shuts down a major port for an extended period and thousands of military-age men are invading our country. My tin hat overheats. Can you say dry run? Who do you think profits from arming illegals? Hey, of course, as Wade already knows, you're speaking to the choir. No, it's completely ridiculous. In a real world, every member of the Biden administration would already be smile money using.
Are we rolling these in the office?
Yeah. Everybody in the Biden administration would already be in prison. In my world, they would already be something else.
Fish food.
The question is. I never thought that we could possibly get this far into destroying America without even the average person grabbing a gun and heading to meet up with the rest of the people to do Second Amendment shit. I just have to throw my shoulders.
Where's the van?
Get in the van. Problem is we all know, J-Dog, it'd be me and you, and there'd be a shootout, and there'd be a van full of Swiss cheese holes, and on the news, they'd talk about the oh my God, I couldn't believe the amount of weapons and thousands of rounds of ammunition.
Well, somebody had to give the 50 away.
No.
Let's put a red dot on it.
Put a red dot on the 50?
Yeah. You see Noreen, you got those lowers? They also make 50s. They got one with a 16-inch barrel. I don't want to be around that muzzle blast.
You know, as devastating as a 50 cal round is, the only way I would ever want to even think about getting another one is it would have to be a semi-automatic Barrett.
You sure? Serbu makes a 50A. And then there's that GM6 Lynx.
Theirs is also semi-automatic.
It also uses Barrett mags.
Hmm. Well, it'd have to be a semi-auto. I don't want another Bolt 50.
I do.
I mean, don't get me wrong, if I still had the one that I had, there is something to say about being able to go like this. I got a BMG 50. Go ahead.
To sight in that new scope, it wasn't at my house very long before somebody was over there fondling on it. Somebody. Looking out the fucking front window to the apartment building next door, he's like, oh man. And I was like, turn the fucking lights off before you do this shit.
Can you imagine someone sitting on their deck? Can you imagine Christine living across from you? Because she's always out there with her la-di-da-di-da, la-di-da. Hey, what is that? Some dude in a yellow house aiming a large gilled barrel. It looks like a fucking hoagie bun.
Probably standing in the front window. Yeah. Without a shirt on.
I tell you though, there was such a drastic improvement after John's break I put on that.
I didn't shoot it before.
You didn't shoot it with the old break?
No.
Just with John's?
Yeah.
Okay, so what did you think about shooting it with John's break on it?
I probably could have shot three times as much ammo as I brought that day. I think I only brought 10 rounds with to sight it in. We needed a little bit more.
I didn't give you any ammo?
No, you sent me the whole box. Oh. You're like, have fun. But I only brought 10 with.
Oh,
like, okay. Because I was like, I don't want to shoot up too much of this ammo.
I was like, I gave a shit. The day that I did the original sight in?
I did go through like all of them, and I picked out a few of the special ones to hold on to.
See, now, the day that I sighted it in was stock. And I would show it, because I don't really care if someone doesn't... I'm not a fake YouTuber. But on the video of my last shot, which was the 13th shot that day...
You're sore?
This is exactly, you're the camera, this is exactly what you saw. I fucking closed my eyes and I was moving out of the way. When I got home, it looked like you took black spray paint and spray painted my arm. I broke like all of the blood vessels.
No, with John's break on it, it was like I said, I would have shot way more ammo, but we only brought 10 rounds left.
But keep in mind, it looked just like this when I shot it. There was no, it didn't have that stock with the 2-inch pad on it. It was an A 2 fixed stock with that stock 3-gill break on it. I was so fucking sore. But, you know, here's the thing, though. Even after shot number 13...
You're like, oh, I just shot a 50 cal.
I just shot a 50 cal.
Oh, I'll probably do it again.
I got some push. My God. Thing is just such a fucking beast. No, I'd love to own one again. And the sad thing is Mikey's got all the reloading stuff. He constantly says, you know, it's like, want me to load up some stuff?
That those Noreens are like $1,700.
Oof.
For a single shot.
Now is that that's the upper, or is that a complete?
It's a complete.
Oh shit, that's...
I think those are the style where when you pull the bolt out, you gotta put the casing in the...
Oh, in it?
In it, and then...
Slides all together? Yeah, I think I've seen that. It's probably better than what...
I really want a McMillan Tac 50 or the Kadex Trimmer 50.
How about a Desert Tactical 50?
I'd take one of those too. But I know the...
You're like almost $10,000 without a scope.
I know the McMillans are badass because that's what that Canadian was shooting them dudes at.
See, the plus on the Desert Tactical is...
You can change the barrel down.
You can just buy a...
Once you buy the gun...
Barrel.
I don't even think they offer just a complete rifle. You got to buy that through a dealer. I think what they were just selling is the action, and then you had to buy the caliber kit separate.
I'm pretty sure because of the size of a 338 Lapua.
Just go up bigger. Why? If you're going to spend that much on ammo, just go bigger. Seven Psalm, just go bigger.
Okay.
I tried when you were like, oh, I'm going to buy a gun from John. And then you said, oh, a 7 Mag. I was like, all right, that's not that bad. And then you're like, oh, I think I'm going to get the 7 Psalm instead. I was like, oh, geez. And then I immediately started looking for ammo. I was like, it's not in stock anywhere.
No.
And it's like it $80 a box.
Yeah, for 20 rounds.
Yeah.
No, but I know when you say but, it like... Here's my thoughts, though. To actually have Sean Huber making me the bullets for that rifle at $3 a shot.
That's not that bad.
No. But trying to just find... It still just hurts because you're talking about $140 for 100 pieces of just brass.
Then you try and make sure you pick them all up.
The other thing that's really been hurting lately is, when I had money, so don't send me any links now, I can't do it, was trying to find the Lapua brass for the Mosin. Mm. Michael actually wants to load me some more Mosin stuff, but the only thing he has is the 311 projectiles.
So you're saying you have to go shoot the Mosin so you can bring him some brass?
I am, for smile money. Even if I go by myself, I'm probably going to go out to Island Lake this week and do... he wanted to see 100-yard groupings for the Mosin and the JP. But I would also like to see 100-yard grouping for the GRG manufacturing and the 24-inch. That GRG is... I really enjoy shooting that GRG. That the day that Jeremy was here and we put the zero on all sorts of stuff, that DRG manufacturing, that thing was like... I think if you actually set nickels down at the berm at 100 yards, you would have gone, yep, got that one, got that one. I mean, Jesus Christ, when we did the AR, the M16 replica build for Mikey, and me and Ray, STL Ray Edwards, we were up at Rob's house. We started by shooting clay pigeons, and then Rob gave us plates, dinner plates. When we shot all the dinner plates and were giggling, We then started shooting the chunks of the dinner plates. And the more that we shot, the smaller it got, all the way down to that. And this is an open sight gun. I can't remember if we gave Mike, no, we didn't give Michael a scope. We just had the open sights. At something like 50 yards, we were, with open sights, we were hitting chunks the size of a quarter. Need some ammo? Okay, Sharky says, get well, Poco.
Got some.
And then Sharky says, Bravo 10.
Hey, would you be surprised if I just pulled the mag out of my pocket?
No, not with you, no. Nothing would surprise me.
Well, that's with, so.
Same shit, Hornady?
Uh-huh. That's one of the house guns.
The house gun. Oh, watching J-Dog stick it in. Poorly. Want me to spit on that?
Okay, let's see how it goes. Over the top. There, now it's in there.
See, I wanted to actually really lock ARs in there. But if they don't have
right,
if they're not a A1 or an A2 grip,
well, the A2 or the you almost need like a fixed carry handle, because otherwise it doesn't really matter.
Yeah, or less.
Or they go through the
because you can put. Wait.
I think it's got to go through the trigger guard.
Well, it's a gate that comes down.
Okay.
And it actually is meant to sit on top of a fixed carry handle.
Okay.
So, I mean, I could technically modify the thing, but I'd have to modify multiple things because
to get a dozen A1s.
Well, that works too. I like your solution.
Mm-hmm. Or A2s.
The thing is I really don't like that grip. My preferred grip is the Hogue.
I know you like the Hogue. I've been trying some new ones out. I really like this one. That's the B5 B23.
The house gun.
One of them.
That doesn't feel bad.
And that's got a more vertical.
Yeah, grip. So when you're...
So it's made for shooting, like, squared up to the target versus the old school where you, like, shoot at an angle, bladed.
Is this thing locked?
This is the button.
Oh. Fuck you, ATF. That's all I gotta say. Ooh.
And that's a absolute co-witness riser on that vortex.
The fuck? Is that like a 1 mil dot?
Something like that, one or two.
You know, some...
So, the story on that dot, I bought an H&R single barrel break action, and somebody had, like, jerry-rigged a scope mount on the front of it, and that scope was on it. I saw it and the price on it, and I googled the sight. I was like, okay, I'll buy it. The price of the gun with the sight was the price of the sight alone.
Fuck, that thing is so I love, some people would probably bitch about a dot that small. God damn, it is so fucking crisp. Like, right there, hovering right on the very, very top of that front sight. I'm shooting in the paper. Doesn't really matter, right? The fuck trigger is this?
I saw Rise Armament.
That would explain. That explains a few things.
Not the high end. I got two of the, I forget. They changed their naming recently on them. But that was one of the older 140s. And I got two of them for like a stupid deal on Optics Planet on that sale. They're like $60 a piece.
Okay, here's something I'm not sure about.
So you got the Folds of Honor or whatever?
Yes.
So that is the same as my other... I have one of them, but not the branded one. The one that they used based off of that one.
See, this one doesn't do it as badly as the as Alice. But if you fire and go for the reset, Alice, you can actually feel that heavy like ka-chunk on the trigger, but it doesn't affect the reset. It always is there for the reset. This one's a lot more smooth. But I know the trigger has to be the same, so I don't know.
That's got the, like, I have that trigger, not branded the Folds of Honor. That's the 343 from Rise Armament.
Yeah. Cause the only you said that's the 140?
Yep.
That's the one that was in the Justin gun.
I don't know what you did with that. I don't remember.
Actually, Salty gave me that whole lower.
Because it was it too much of a hassle to send it all, or?
Yeah, kind of, and he had...
He already
had two possible lowers to complete the mission.
Okay.
But I have a brand new one, and I said I would make good on that trigger, and I would send him another 140.
I think for the money, you can't beat it.
Oh. Well, I... You don't even need to do this because you've already done that on yours.
Yeah.
It's just, I mean, look at that reset.
It's so short.
It's
these things shoot faster than you want to shoot, really.
And I constantly bitch about this, so I'm always happy to continue to do doing that. I fucking hate these vertical grips. But this was a gift from Poco, and it completes what
Justin found. Justin rifle.
It completes. So I leave it on there, and he goes, you know, if you really have to, it still can be a forward hand grip, and he's right. And
or
if
you just reach farther forward and grab it like that.
Or you come back on it, which I have it. I have the my fleshlight set up for it. Or if you have to, say, do shit where you're, like, say, on a fence or something like that. Yeah, so, because Poco sent it to me, I won't take it off of the rifle.
Oi.
Oi. Ever try this during Equinox?
Hmm. No.
We've done that with the broom. That's freaky. We left the job site once, and I had it balancing, and it was still standing the next morning. Oh, a month later, I couldn't get it to stand at all.
The Equinox.
Need a back rub? I'll call McClain. You need a beverage? Oh, you're good on beverages? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
Need a nap?
Yeah.
Well, that is it. That could easily be easy to turn on a video and take a nap because I'm going to need to make dinner. Oh, so, Pete again. Which is longer, The 5906 is longer than the 6906.
It's about a half inch longer.
The 5906 is about a half inch longer than the 6906. Matt, if you and J-Dog are hungry, I just finished cooking up a bunch of steak. Gonna cook up some crab in a bit as well. We're just finishing the review. He's probably gonna need to take a nap.
Yeah.
And I have dinner plans. Okay, going to the club. Wow. Sharky. Guess my cheers all didn't shoot that first comment. Never made it. Then he says, 1 hour, 5 minutes and 50 seconds, I'd love a piece of Snow White. And now I hope the noodle would stick on the next one. Salty, double naked fun in the sun. Sharky, 1 hour, 15 minutes and 30 seconds. You fuck. Nah, all good. You caved and messaged me. Yes, I did. Sharky SH, I'm confused. Normally the schoolgirls are sweet, yet somehow this one is wielding a horse whip. Now I'm intrigued. Rich, cheers, clubbers. Cheers, Rich. J-Dog, there.
Yeah.
He's there. Bad, howdy, clubbers. Happy Easter to everyone. Yes, happy Easter. Sharky, there's nothing like when you get to see the bat signal. Lava, crafting cocktails. Really enjoyed the video. Thank you for the honest feedback. Cheers to you and all the intergalactic misfits. That's awesome. Yeah, I will, let's see. Just letting them know, I will review their other gift, the Michelada, later this week. Now I'm curious. What do they have? They have 59 subscribers and 18 videos. So, my recommendation to show the love, especially for a company. See, it's always about customer service to me. They saw a bad review and wanted to turn it around, and they did. So what do they have? They have best Bloody Mary mix, how to make a Bloody Mary, best Michelada recipe. Oh my God, they have other, they have Express Martini. I didn't realize they had some other things in their lineup. Okay, very cool. Okay, that was the last comment. And the very last one. I don't know about his review. The original, the classic, the apple, I would put that in spot number 3. So, in my order that I would purchase these would be strawberry. Ooh, that one's full. I would do strawberry, then the mimosa, then the original first press, and last place would go to the blackberry. And that's the same for J-Dog. Okay.
Don't drink four of them on an empty stomach.
Don't drink four on an empty stomach. I'm at least ahead of you. Christine made the breakfast bowl for me. Oofta. Yeah, you're more than happy to go sprawl out on the couch. I might walk over and see what Matt's doing. Otherwise, I'm making Philly cheesesteaks for dinner tonight. That was my pack from... You know what's funny? Those four mags took almost 3 months to show up.
There's some more. There's three more. And 20.
Oh,
there's a bag.
Oh, these ones are mine. Those ones are Northern's. Oh, now I'm confused. There's a lot of mags. Actually, I think both of these go with Northern Storage.
There's a lot of mags in here.
Yeah. Mine the tactical originally came with three mags, and then I ordered three more, so there'd be six for the tactical, and I ordered one of the extended, and this was the original one, so this one. Either will go with the pistol I have yet to purchase. No matter how it works out, if I have to sell blood at the plasma center, I have to get another VP9.
Because that one's sand?
I can't get rid of the other one. I just... The last time I shot it, it was... When I can openly admit that I am not a precision marksman... And like J-Dog's already said, stop drinking fucking coffee before you go out to the range. Nice. That, I still outshot this one with that one. But now that one was exclusively sights, and this one was the green dot, and all I saw because of coffee was this. It's like, Jesus Christ, if I could just turn the green dot off and just have shot the iron sights, I probably would have had the same results as the other one, but holy shit, yeah. Eric, get your shit together. Don't drink less coffee. Okay, gonna do one refresh, and then we're out of here. I'm almost afraid to look at the time. I'm gonna guess 1:47. 1:42. Okay, that's good. Okay, so cheers, and probably see you tomorrow. Maybe tomorrow, look at that Michelada from Lava, which means Tuesday I need to look at the other one. Maybe. Cheers.